My primary school here, and then when I was 13, we all moved to the States because my parents wanted to get their PhDs. I lived in the States for like 8-9 years, then I moved back to Kenya in 2006. Professionally, I'm a makeup artist. I also run Bayesa Africa, which is my YouTube channel. One of the things I realized a long time ago is that there isn't enough content on YouTube, beauty-wise, for women of color. And the content that I provide or I produce is of course on YouTube, but it's also changing so many people's lives. I'm getting emails from people all over the world saying that they've learned how to do makeup on themselves and also on other women because of what they see on my channel. So it's huge. The excitement for me comes in the creation. I love process. In fact, most, if not all of the time, I get on set without knowing what I'm going to do. It's not pre-planned. Most of it, I have a model and I'm like, okay, let's try this. And we try it and it ends up working out or it ends up not working out and I start over again. I believe that a legacy is something that should go on when you're not there. And Bayesa Africa, the YouTube channel, doesn't have to rely on me personally to be there for it to reach many people, which is, I think, the beauty of YouTube, the beauty of Google, is that you don't have to physically put in hours. You don't have to go to work at 8 to 5 for you to make a difference. It's your work that's making a difference for you. And so that's what I think legacy is. I want the legacy of Bayesa Africa to impact women 10, 15, 20 years from now, and not just at this moment.